Welcome to a lesson on adding and subtracting rational expressions with like and unlike denominators. Let's first consider when we have like denominators. In order to add or subtract when we have like denominators, the denominator remains the same and we add or subtract the numerators. And this is true as long as u, v, and w are real numbers, variables, or algebraic expressions, and w doesn't equal zero. W can't equal zero because division by zero is undefined. For our first example, let's consider 2/9 plus 1/9. Notice how we have a common denominator or like denominator of 9. And therefore, to find the sum, the denominator remains 9. And we add the numerators, which gives us 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. The sum is 3/9. But this fraction does simplify because there is a common factor of 3 between the numerator and denominator. To simplify, we will divide the numerator and denominator by 3. 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3. The simplified sum is 1/3. Next, we have a difference. But again, notice how we do have a common denominator of x minus 4. To find the difference, the denominator remains x minus 4. And now we subtract the numerators, which gives us the quantity 3x plus 1 minus the quantity 2x plus 5. And we do need the parentheses here to make sure we subtract the entire numerator of the second fraction. And now we simplify the numerator. We have the quantity 3x plus 1, and then we have minus the quantity 2x plus 5. We need to subtract both terms inside the parentheses, so we have minus 2x and then minus 5. Or if it's helpful, we can also think of distributing a negative 1 here because of the subtraction to clear the parentheses. And now combining like terms in the numerator, we have 3x minus 2x, which is 1x or x, and then 1 minus 5 is negative 4, giving us minus 4. And again, notice how this does simplify because we have a common factor of x minus 4 between the numerator and denominator. Before we simplify though, notice how the denominator would be equal to 0 when x is 4. So let's make a note here, x can't equal positive 4. And now simplifying, x minus 4 divided by itself simplifies to 1. So the given difference is 1 as long as x doesn't equal 4. And now let's talk about adding or subtracting when we have unlike denominators. To add or subtract rational expressions with unlike denominators, we need to rewrite each expression using the least common denominator, or LCD. The LCD contains all the different factors of the denominators, and each factor must be repeated the maximum number of times it occurs in any of the denominators. And here are the steps we will follow. Number one, factor all the denominators. Two, determine the LCD from the factors. Three, multiply the numerator and denominator of each fraction by any missing factors to form the LCD. 4, add or subtract the fractions, and then 5, simplify if possible. Let's take a look at some examples. Here we have 1/30th plus 5/12. We begin by writing out the prime factorization of 30 and 12. The prime factorization of 30 is 2 times 3 times 5, and the prime factorization of 12 is 2 times 2 times 3. And now we will build the LCD by analyzing the prime factorization of the denominators. Beginning with the factor of 2, the first denominator contains one factor of 2, the second denominator contains two factors of 2, the LCD must contain two factors of 2, the first denominator is missing a factor of 2, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by a factor of 2. Now moving to the factor of 3, notice how both denominators already contain one factor of 3. And now looking at the factor of 5, the first denominator contains one factor of 5. The second denominator contains zero factors of 5. The second denominator is missing a factor of 5. And therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by a factor of 5. Notice now we have the LCD, which contains two factors of 2, a factor of 3, and a factor of 5. 1/30th is equivalent to 2 over 2 times 3 times 5 times 2, which is 60, plus 5/12 is the equivalence to 25/60. And now that we have a common denominator, we can go ahead and add. The denominator remains the same, which is 60, and the numerator is 2 + 25, which is 27. So the sum is 27/60, but this does simplify because 27 and 60 share a common factor of 3. To simplify, we divide the numerator and denominator by 3. 27 divided by 3 is equal to 9. 60 divided by 3 is equal to 20. The simplified sum is 9/20. For the next example, we begin by writing out the prime factorization of the two denominators. We will also expand the variable factors. So for the first fraction, the prime factorization of 8 is 2 times 2 times 2, and then we have 1 factor of x and 2 factors of y. For the second fraction, the prime factorization of 12 is 2 times 2 times 3, and then we have 2 factors of x and a factor of y. And now beginning with the factor of 2, the first denominator contains 3 factors of 2. The second denominator contains 2 factors of 2. The second denominator is missing a factor of 2. We multiply the numerator and denominator by a factor of 2. Now looking at the factor of 3, the first denominator contains 0 factors of 3. The second denominator contains 1 factor of 3. The first denominator is missing a factor of 3. We multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. And now moving along to the variable factors, the first denominator contains 1 factor of x. The second denominator contains 2 factors of x. The first denominator is missing a factor of x. We multiply the numerator and denominator by a factor of x. And now for the last factor of y, the first denominator contains 2 factors of y. The second denominator contains 1 factor of y. The second denominator is missing a factor of y, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by a factor of y. And now we have the least common denominator. The first given fraction is equivalent to 15x all over 2 times 2 times 2 times 3 is 24. And then we have 2 factors of x and 2 factors of y, which gives us x squared y squared. The LCD is 24x squared y squared. Minus the second fraction is equivalent to 14y over the LCD of 24x squared y squared. And now that we have a common denominator, we can go ahead and subtract. The denominator remains the same. And now we subtract the numerators, which gives us 15x minus 14y. 15x minus 14y does not factor, and therefore this does not simplify, and therefore we are done. But notice how if x or y was equal to 0, we would have division by 0. So let's make a note here, x can't equal 0, or y can't equal 0. For this example, we have 4 over the quantity x plus 3, and notice x plus 3 does not factor, plus 2 over the quantity x minus 2. X minus 2 also does not factor. And therefore, the least common denominator must contain 1 factor of x plus 3 and 1 factor of x minus 2. The first denominator is missing the factor of x minus 2, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by x minus 2. The second denominator is missing the factor of x plus 3, and therefore we multiply the numerator and denominator by x plus 3. And now that we have a common denominator, we can go ahead and add. The denominator is going to remain 1 factor of x plus 3 and 1 factor of x minus 2. And the order of these factors does not matter. And the numerator is going to be 4 times the quantity x minus 2 plus 2 times the quantity x plus 3. We need to be careful here. We cannot start simplifying because we cannot simplify across addition or subtraction. The next step is to simplify the numerator by distributing 4 here, distributing 2 here, and then combining like terms. Distributing 4 gives us 4x minus 8. Distributing 2 gives us plus 2x plus 6. And now combining like terms in the numerator, 4x plus 2x is 6x, and negative 8 plus 6 is negative 2, giving us minus 2. And this is still over the quantity x plus 3 times the quantity x minus 2. And now let's factor the numerator and see if we have any common factors between the numerator and denominator. Factoring 6x minus 2, we factor out the greatest common factor of 2, which gives us 2 times the quantity 3x minus 1. And notice how we don't have any common factors other than 1 between the numerator and denominator, and therefore we are done. But once again, x can't equal negative 3 or positive 2, because if it did, we'd have division by 0. Let's make a note here, x can't equal negative 3 or x can't equal positive 2. Let's take a look at one more example. Again, we don't have a common denominator. We begin by factoring the two denominators. Y squared plus 4x minus 32 factors into two binomial factors. The factors of y squared are y and y. The factors of negative 32 that add to positive 4 are positive 8 and negative 4. Now we factor y squared plus 10y plus 16. The factors of y squared, y and y. The factors of 16 that add to 10 are positive 8 and positive 2. And now let's build the least common denominator. Notice both denominators contain one factor of y plus 8. Moving to the factor of y minus 4, the first denominator contains one factor of y minus 4. The second denominator is missing a factor of y minus 4. We multiply the numerator and denominator of the second fraction by y minus 4. And now the last factor is y plus 2, and the first denominator is missing a factor of y plus 2. We multiply the numerator and denominator of the first fraction by y plus 2. Notice that LCD contains three factors. And again, the order of the factors does not matter. And now subtracting the numerators, we have 4 times the quantity y plus 2 minus 2 times the quantity y minus 4. Again, we cannot simplify across this subtraction. The next step is to clear the parentheses in the numerator by distributing and then combining like terms. Because of the subtraction here, we distribute negative 2. Distributing 4 gives us 4y plus 8. Distributing negative 2 gives us minus 2y. And then negative 2 times negative 4 is positive 8, giving us plus 8. Combining like terms in the numerator, 4y minus 2y is 2y, and then 8 plus 8 is 16, giving us plus 16. And now let's factor the numerator by factoring out the greatest common factor of 2. Factoring out 2 gives us 2 times the quantity y plus 8. Notice how this does simplify because we have a common factor of y plus 8 between the numerator and denominator. Before we simplify though, we do need to recognize that the denominator would be 0 if y was equal to negative 8, positive 4, or negative 2. We need to make a note of this before simplifying. So let's make a note here, y can't equal negative 8, or y can't equal positive 4, or y can't equal negative 2. And now simplifying, y plus 8 divided by itself simplifies to 1. The simplified difference is 2 divided by the product of y minus 4 and y plus 2. I hope you found this helpful.